The Standard Missile 6, officially designated RIM-174, Standard Extended Range Active Missile, or SM-6, is one of the most versatile and advanced naval missiles in service today. Developed by Raytheon for the United States Navy, it was designed to provide a single weapon that could counter a wide range of threats. Unlike earlier generations of the Standard Missile family, which were specialized for particular missions, the SM-6 is built for flexibility. It can engage enemy aircraft, cruise missiles, and ballistic missiles in their terminal phase, and in more recent years, it has also been adapted for use against ships and land targets. The idea behind the SM-6 was to give the fleet a weapon that could respond to evolving air and missile threats without needing to design a new missile for every situation. The result is a multi-mission interceptor that can reach long distances, operate under the control of a network battle system, and deliver precise effects in complex environments. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why SM-6 missile is an awesome weapon. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The SM-6 traces its lineage to the long-running Standard Missile family that began in the 1960s. Its structure is based on the proven SM-2 airframe, but it incorporates advanced electronics, processors, and an active radar seeker derived from the AIM-120 AMRAAM air-to-air missile. This hybrid approach gave the missile a strong aerodynamic foundation and a state-of-the-art guidance package. By combining the AIM-120 seeker with the SM-2's airframe and propulsion system, engineers created a weapon that could engage targets independently in its terminal phase. Earlier Standard missiles relied on the ship's radar to illuminate the target throughout the engagement, but the SM-6's active seeker allows it to home in on its own once it nears the target. This capability greatly increases engagement flexibility, especially when multiple missiles are fired at different threats. The SM-6 measures about 6.6 meters in length and around 0.53 meters in diameter. It weighs roughly 1,500 kilograms, 3,300 pounds at launch. The missile uses a two-stage solid propellant rocket system, a booster that provides initial acceleration, and a second stage that sustains flight to the target. Its maximum speed is estimated to exceed Mach 3.5, allowing it to close on fast-moving threats at high altitude or sea level. The missile carries a blast fragmentation warhead that detonates through proximity or contact fusing. While this type of warhead is typical for anti-air warfare, it has proven effective against surface and land targets as well. The combination of speed, precision guidance, and high explosive yield allows it to destroy or disable a variety of threats, from incoming missiles to surface vessels. The SM-6 employs a sophisticated, multi-layered guidance system. It starts with an inertial navigation system that steers it along the projected flight path. Mid-course updates are transmitted from the launching ship or another sensor platform using a secure data link. These updates allow the missile to adjust its trajectory based on the latest target information. As it closes in, the missile switches to its active radar seeker, which searches for and locks onto the target autonomously. It can also use semi-active radar homing if the ship chooses to illuminate the target, providing flexibility for different engagement scenarios. This layered approach means the SM-6 can hit targets well beyond the radar horizon of the launching ship, relying on other platforms in the network for targeting data. A major strength of the SM-6 is its role in network-centric operations. It integrates seamlessly with the Aegis combat system and can accept targeting information from other ships, aircraft, or land-based sensors. This allows what is known as engage-on-remote capability, where a ship can launch a missile at a target it cannot directly see, based on data from another sensor platform. This networked approach expands the reach and survivability of naval forces. A destroyer or cruiser equipped with SM-6 missiles can defend not only itself but also nearby ships or coastal assets from long-range threats. In joint operations, the missile can even be cued by Army or Air Force sensors, providing a bridge between different branches of the military for integrated air and missile defense. The SM-6's versatility lies in its ability to perform multiple roles without hardware changes. In its anti-air warfare configuration, it can engage enemy aircraft and cruise missiles at ranges up to 460 kilometers, 290 miles. In the terminal ballistic missile defense role, it intercepts incoming ballistic threats as they re-enter the atmosphere. Raytheon and the U.S. Navy have conducted several successful tests demonstrating the missile's ability to destroy ballistic targets during the final moments of their trajectory. Recent developments have also turned the SM-6 into an offensive weapon. By using its long-range, active seeker, and precision guidance, the missile can strike enemy ships and land targets at extended distances. This capability, sometimes called dual use or surface strike, turns the SM-6 into a tool for both defense and offense, giving naval commanders new options in contested regions. The SM-6 has been fielded across multiple classes of U.S. Navy surface combatants, including Arleigh Burke-class destroyers and Ticonderoga-class cruisers. It is fired from the standard Mark 41 vertical launching system, allowing it to coexist with other weapons such as the SM-2, SM-3, and Tomahawk. Testing has demonstrated consistent success against high-speed targets and complex attack profiles. The Standard Missile 6 represents a major step forward in naval weapons design. It merges the proven reliability of the Standard Missile family with modern sensors, guidance, and networking. By performing multiple missions, from fleet air defense to ballistic missile interception and even surface strike, it consolidates what once required several different missile types. Each SM-6 missile costs several million dollars, depending on configuration and production lot. This makes it one of the most expensive interceptors in the U.S. Navy's inventory. However, its range, flexibility, and reliability justify the cost for high-value engagements. The missile is not intended for massed fire against inexpensive threats. Instead, it complements shorter-range, lower-cost systems like the Evolved Sea Sparrow Missile, ESSM, and Rolling Airframe Missile, RAM. Together, these weapons form a layered defense network in which the SM-6 serves as the outer shield, designed to destroy threats before they can close with the fleet. As the maritime battle space grows faster and more complex, the SM-6 gives commanders a flexible, long-range, and intelligent weapon that can adapt to the fight. In short, the SM-6 is not just another missile, it is a key element in the evolving architecture of modern naval combat. The SM-6 continues to evolve. Raytheon and the Navy are developing improved variants with greater range, upgraded seekers, and enhanced networking capabilities. The next generation version, often referred to as Block 1B, will feature a larger diameter rocket motor for extended reach and higher speed. Efforts are also underway to improve production rates and reduce costs per unit as demand grows among U.S. and allied forces.